So if you're listening to this, you've probably figured out that I am starting to go online. It really happened just yesterday on June 8th, 2016. Anyone who knows me will tell you that I'm the person who's been resisting Facebook and the social media world my whole life. I swore I would never get a Facebook or join Twitter or have a YouTube because I really didn't feel like there was much that I could contribute. While I enjoyed the, you know, pictures of amazing meals and recipes and photos of people's lives that would be filtered down to me through my friends and family, if they would see something and they would be like, yes, we need to show this to you. You know, I always enjoyed that they would trickle in, but I never really wanted to jump full force in until yesterday. Two nights ago, I can say that I woke up in the middle of the night and the 12 audio podcasts or whatever you want to call them that precede this one just came to me. It was after midnight, closer to 2 a.m. And I remember just waking up, going to my computer, looking for whatever the voice recorder available on it. It's a new computer. I had to figure all that out. And then I just hit record. And it was like the 12 pieces just came together the way they were meant to. I listened back at them a few times and came to the realization that despite the flaws in wording or missteps along the way, they were perfectly imperfect because they were authentic and they were true. And they were clips that I couldn't have written, you know, pre-planned out and just like this one. So yesterday, my wonderful, what I call marketing team, consisting of current and former research assistants and students who believe in me and the research project and, you know, who have contributed to making this what it is. We had our first marketing meeting at 1 o'clock, and by 3 o'clock, we had, you know, set up the basis of my website, of this YouTube, and of Facebook, which still might shut down after 3 days because I originally told them I didn't want to have any friends until I realized in the first seconds that I opened it today how quickly people from around the world were connecting. And I know my brother and other people in my life have been telling me that all the time, but I really never had anything to say. So I guess what I've learned is the people that I studied, and it was my former, you know, methamphetamine cooks, actually showed me, you know, what I needed to do and gave me something to say. And so this set of audio clips is my first attempt to reach out to a broader audience. And I thank everyone that allowed me to interview them for helping me find my voice and helping me have something meaningful that I might actually have to say. So here we go.